You probably have heard a lot about AI agents, agentic AI system, and it makes you feel that you are already being left behind. But most business owners and marketers I talk to jump straight to AI agents without understanding basic AI automation. It's just like wanting to fly without learning to walk. And the truth is, even if it's just a simple AI automation, it will give you immediate ROI for your business or work. My committee members actually suggest me to cover these AI automation topics, so thanks for that. In this video, I'll show you how to build your very first AI automation. We'll keep it simple, less technical, but powerful. A social content AI automation that generates posts, images, and documents all from a single entry in Google Sheets. This way, you'll master the fundamentals before worrying about scaling. First of all, if you're confused about different terms in workflow automation, it actually can be viewed in a very simple progression. Manual workflow, which is mainly human-driven. Basic automation, an automated workflow without using AI. AI automation, an AI-enhanced automated workflow involves the use of AI models to add intelligence. Advanced AI agents that is highly adaptive with decision-making. I highly encourage you to check out this video to get this concept right. And there's so many different AI automation settings. But basically, they all follow this structure. Start with a trigger that detects an event or condition. Is it menu trigger or schedule trigger? For example, an online form submission trigger when someone fills out a support form. Then the input nooks that prepare the data for the AI models, like extracting the submitted question and info. Then the AI model nooks where it will perform your actual action, like summarizing the question into a ticket. And finally, the output nooks to discover the output in your specified format, like sending it as a message to Slack. So whenever you build your AI automation, do not start with the tools or platform. Always start with your design process and the structure. It will make things so much easier. In the coming demo, I'll be using the cloud version of AnyN, a very popular AI automation platform. But if you prefer, you can also run locally with self-hosting. I will leave all the setup links in the description. An important tip for you is to always check if you're running the latest AnyN version, so to make sure you can access to the latest node configuration and security fix. If you use the cloud version, you can go to the workplace settings under the admin panel and then upgrade your AnyN version to the latest stable version and save changes. Okay, our first AI automation is a social content creation automation. I know this is one of the key pain points that most marketers are facing. So we have this master social content planner. It's a Google Sheets outlining the social media planning for your company LinkedIn account. It already has different columns: the target published date, the planned topic about the post, the status, and the draft link, which will be a Google document that we're going to create. Note, I intentionally just put only one entry because I want to show you how we will add more entries later and trigger the automation. As I said, the very first step of an AI automation starts with a trigger and then input. Now on AnyN and create a new workflow. Here we are on the canvas, it's blank. We will add the trigger, so click add first step. Since we're not going to trigger manually, because we want it to run automatically whenever we add new topics to the planner without manual work. So select on app event and pick Google Sheets. So you will see there are three types of trigger. We will pick the on row add. So that means it will be triggered whenever there is a new entry detected on the Google Sheets. And here you will see different parameters to set, but don't be scared, it's simple. So first, you have to make sure you are already connected to your Google Sheets account. And then poll times means how often this automation should be triggered. We just set it to every minute as it catches new entry quick enough while not overloading your system. And whenever you have done configure a node, I highly suggest you click finish test event or test execute before you move on to make sure there's no issue. Now you can see it has successfully retrieved the content from the Google Sheets, which contain one item only. If you think it's very technical and you get a headache, you can also toggle to view in a table or schema format. Now a bonus tip is to use this pinned data. When it's enabled, it will save this node's current output data. So this will save you money, especially if you are calling the AI model's API calls while testing, so you are not regenerating the same data every time. Highly recommended for testing purpose. And when we exit the canvas, we will see there is a pinned icon with one item loaded. And if you haven't enabled the pinned data, you should see a tick icon instead. So in the next step, we're going to add some conditional logic as we want to make sure the AI models will only process those social topics which have an opening status. So this will prevent wasting API calls on topics we have already processed. So to add this logic, we will select from the flow session, pick if to route the item. So here you can see the input that is from the Google Sheets note. So we will drag the status as the checking condition, and we want to make sure it is empty. Again, click execute step to check everything is properly set up. So it is executed successfully. We have already set up our triggers and conditions. Next is adding AI to generate the actual content. Now it's time to add an AI model because it's AI automation. So you can see a list of AI nodes, AI agent node, native AI models node like Anthropic, Gemini, OpenAI. So I will just pick ChatGPT, but feel free to pick whatever you prefer. So you will see there are different predefined actions. Pick message and model. Again, make sure you already set up the credentials by getting the API key on the OpenAI platform in order to call the ChatGPT model on any end. So I will put all the resources below if you need it. And then pick your preferred model. I will pick the GPT 5 mini because mini models cost almost 10x less than the full models, have higher token limits. So it's important when automating at scale. So refer the link below for more details. As for the message, you can see the prompt field and the role. When the role is set to user, that means this is the actual prompt we will send to ChatGPT. So we will ask it to generate a LinkedIn post draft about the topic. Now drag the topic, which is a dynamic value, into this prompt and make sure it is no more than 200 words. Then you will see the results section that gives you a preview of what the final prompt message will look like. We are not done yet. We can also set a system prompt by adding one more message and set the role to system. So toggle to the expression view, and here you can define your custom instructions, the behavior, tone, or rules for the AI throughout the conversation. So you can ensure every post follows your brand voice consistently. And we will put the tone of voice and the social post template for ChatGPT to follow whenever it generates the post draft. If this step is too much for you, you can definitely skip it as optional. All right, we are all set. Now let's test it. So the draft is generated successfully. It looks good and it's being wrapped in a content view. So we are ready to move on to the next step. And again, pin this output data so we can save the tokens for testing purposes. Now let's also generate an image for this social post. Select the ChatGPT note again and pick generate an image. And we will pick the GPT image model. An important note is that in order to run the GPT image model on any end, you have to verify your organization account first on the OpenAI platform. Then use this prompt to ask it to first translate the post into an image scene idea and then generate the image. So this way it can create more relevant visuals than just converting text directly to images, and the results will be much better. Again, we'll drag this dynamic content in the prompt, and you can always preview the actual prompt in the result. Now execute the step. After some time, the generated image is ready and it looks good, it's relevant to the post content and also good for business context, but you can always adjust the style that you like in the prompt. AI is now creating posts and images, so let's organize and deliver everything automatically. Now let's first upload the generated image to Google Drive. So add the Google Drive note, pick upload file. So for the file name, we will use the publish date for the post. So this will help you easily find any specific image or post later when managing dozens of files. So go back to the Google Sheet trigger note and drag the publish date data as the image file name view, and make sure you select the right folder to store the generated image. Then execute the step. So everything is set up now, and you can see here is the Google Drive link for the upload image, and we can actually check the image file on Google Drive as well. Now we are ready to combine the full post and the image into our Word document. So add a Google document note and pick create a document. So on the input panel, you can see all the generated responses from a previous note that we can retrieve here. So pick the right folder name and set the file name as the published date and the topic. Then execute the step. So we can see the new document has been successfully created with a document ID. But since it doesn't have any content yet, so we are going to add another Google document note. But this time is for the update action. So drag the generated document ID to the ID field. For the action, here we need to specify what would be the actual content. So we will first drag the generated post draft from the ChatGPT note and then include the web view link that will link back to the generated post image, and then execute the step and check the outputs. So now it returns a success message. And again, we can actually go back to the drive and we can now see there is a new new document being created with our specified file name, and it contains the LinkedIn post details and the link for the post visuals that we can access and download. So everything is well set up. But we still need to update the Google Sheet status. Again, add the conditional logic that only move on to the next step if the returned document ID is not empty, so we can prevent updating the sheets if the creation process fails. Then add the Google Sheets note again, and this time pick the update role action. So select our master social post planner file again, and we will use the publish date as the matching column. That means NAN will know exactly which column as the identifier. Then drag the publish date value to this view. So we will mark the status as complete. For the draft link, we will work back the Google document link using this pattern and the generated document ID. And always double check the result to make sure it is a well-formatted hyperlink. Now execute the step. So you can see the Google Sheets has been updated automatically with the complete status and a document link that will link you back to the actual post content. And now we have a ready to deploy automation. A bonus tip is to add a wait note. So every time after ChatGPT generate the post draft, we will wait some time before it start the next step of image generation. The reason for this is we want to prevent hitting OpenAI's rate limit, which might break your automation, especially if your Google Sheets have a lot of row entries. So for now, we will just set 1 minute, which should be safe. Now this is exciting. Let's put this automation in production and add more entries, just like in a real situation. Now make sure you unpin the data for all the nooks, as the pinned data would always use test data instead of the real new entries. And turn this automation to the active state. Now this automation is already live, and we regularly check the Google Sheets for new entries every minute and trigger the execution. So we will add the new entries to this Google Sheets, and on any end, we can toggle to the execution view, and you can see the automation is already running. And that means it has detected the new entries I put and is now triggering the workflow. And after around few minutes, the status and the draft link is automatically added to this master planner. And that is the beauty of AI automation. Everything is automatically done. And we can check back the post draft link one by one. And I like the draft. It is following the tone of voice and structure as specified. Of course, this is just a draft, and you should never just directly use it without adding your own tone of voice and unique insights. Also, with the post image that is ready to download, and they're also being uploaded on the Google Drive. So this is perfect. Now, if you want to go one step further, you could even add Gmail as the last note. So every time when a post draft is created and a status has been complete, you or your team will automatically get an email notification with the document link. So search for the Gmail note, pick the send a message action. Again, make sure you have already connected your Gmail account on any end. Then specify the recipient email. For the sake of demo, I'll just send it back to myself. As for the email subject, we will include the post topic with this pattern. And then keep the email type as HTML format. Then put a simple email message together with the draft link generated. So for the demo purpose, this time we'll just skip the execution step and directly add another new entry to trigger the whole automation again. But you should always test the step first before a full run. And after a minute, I successfully received this email with the correct topic included in the email subject and a draft link and a body message, and it is even shown as an attachment. So everything is perfectly set up from end to end. Of course, still a lot of areas to enhance, but this is definitely ready to use. So now whenever you have some new trending topics to write social content about, you can just drop them into this master planner and it will automatically trigger the automation for you. And you can always enhance this AI automation, like adding more conditional logic, what it should do if the status fails, or add some more step in between to search for web data. So there's so many possibilities, and it will immediately save you time once you have this setup. Join my community if you want to learn how to be more thoughtful of using AI in marketing or digital business. You will get access to all the actual prompts I use in my channel videos, our regular live sections, and all the extra content. I hope to see you there. And before you go, also check out this video about building AI agents using this simple method. Once you have a better idea about what is an AI agent versus an AI automation, I will see you next time.